So here's a question we can ask ourselves. Can we guarantee an absolute maximum and an absolute minimum for a function? And this is and. A function that would have both an absolute maximum and an absolute minimum. Because here's the deal. This function that we looked at before has an absolute maximum, but doesn't have an absolute minimum. So maybe rather than saying, can we guarantee, what can we do to guarantee that? Well, to answer the question that's on the board here, can we guarantee an absolute minimum or maximum? Yes. And my claim is, it's going to take two things to do it. So, yes, if your function is, one, continuous, no holes, no jumps, no asymptotes, continuous function, and two, if your function is restricted to the interval a, b, where a and b are both included. Here's the thing to think about. Let's just imagine this situation in action. Imagine you're looking not along the entire x-axis, but you're only looking at an interval between a and b. And in particular, you are including a and including b. So your function is going to have some value at a, and your function is going to have some value at b. So here's sort of the picture of our function. Here's our a, f of a, here's our b, f of b. Included the a and the b. And now, the function is only going to exist between there, and it must be continuous. Now, you know what it means for a function to be continuous? That means its graph is a connected path. So we're not going to be able to pick up our pencil here as we move from the value at f of a to the value at f of b. And think about this. If we don't pick up our pencil along the way, I mean, maybe along the way, we end up traveling up a certain amount, but we're going to have to get our way back down to that value at f of b. So even, like, we can't travel up forever, because in order to be continuous, the graph has to be connected. So I can't go up to infinity. That would make an asymptote. That would cause the function not to be continuous. So in order to graph this connected path, the only way to do it is to ultimately, eventually, somewhere hit a maximum. A maximum which in the entire region of the graph is absolutely a maximum. And similarly, there's going to be some value that you couldn't have gone below. Because you see, to have no absolute minimum, you have to extend down to infinity. But the only way to extend down to infinity is with an asymptote. And we can't have an asymptote because our function is continuous. So ultimately, there's also going to be some absolute minimum value. As it turned out here, the absolute maximum was up at the peak, and the absolute minimum was over here at an endpoint, but so be it. The long story short is, because we restricted to this interval, including a and b, because our function was continuous, we had ourselves an absolute maximum and an absolute minimum. And now, my claim is that you need both of these things in order to guarantee an absolute maximum and an absolute minimum. Note, both restrictions required. Why is this? Note, if not continuous, what can happen? Well, imagine you're going from that point at f of a to that point of f of b, but now, if you're not continuous, if you were allowed to be continuous, well, you could have an asymptote. And if you could have an asymptote, there's your function. And hell, the way that I drew this function, it happened to have an absolute minimum, but it's got no absolute maximum. And we want to guarantee that we have both an absolute maximum and an absolute minimum. And you can't guarantee that if the function's not continuous, because if the function's not continuous, you could have an asymptote. However, if you restrict the function to being continuous, you can have no asymptotes. You have to be a connected path, and on your way from A to B, you could have only got so far up and so far down. We also had this restriction about a comma b where that was closed. Note, if the interval is not closed, well, if the interval is not closed to where you had an open boundary on A or B, I claim that could become a problem because you see, let's just say, for example, that the boundary is open at B. Well, the boundary, say, even we'll close the boundary at A and demand that the function exists at A. But let's just say, hypothetically here, that we're dealing with the interval A comma B where B is not included. Well, if B is not included, we don't have to get all the way to B. We just have to get really close to B. And that presents a problem, doesn't it? Because you could have an asymptote at x equals B. You never actually have to get to B. And if you never actually have to get to B, you could use that line at B as an asymptote that you approach, never touch, and you would not have an absolute max or min. But the long story short is, as long as you exist on a closed region from A to B, and as long as you're continuous, you have no way around reaching a max and a min. If you exist at A, if you exist at B, and you're continuous in between, you can only go down so low, and you can only go down so high. You'll have an absolute maximum wherever that turns out to be, and you'll have an absolute minimum wherever that turns out to be.